everyone. Welcome to the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Conservation Connect. My name is Chelsea McKinney, your host, as we explore conservation careers, fascinating animals, and all kinds of technology that conservation professionals use to study and help wildlife. Today, we're coming to you from a stream. Well, an indoor stream. In this very stream is one of the coolest fish you could ever imagine, the brook trout. These gorgeous fish are native to the cool, clear-flowing streams of the Appalachian Mountains. Just the presence of brook trout in a stream tells you it's probably very clean water and a very healthy ecosystem. Joining us today, we have Dr. Nathaniel Hitt, a scientist that actually made this entire indoor stream. Dr. Hitt, thank you so much for being with us today.
Thanks, Chelsea.
All right, you got to tell us, how did you become interested in fish?
Well, I've always loved fish, and I've always loved fishing. I grew up hiking and exploring the mountains of Appalachia. And I also love a good head dunk in a cold mountain stream. So, yeah, I've always been interested in fish in the mountains out here.
And why did you end up making an indoor stream like this?
Well, we wanted to understand, you know, what's going to happen to fish as climate change happens. We wanted to understand how fish survive in these mountain streams. And so we've developed this system so that we can take what we see in nature and simplify it in ways and develop tests and experiments based on that.
Now, what kinds of things are you able to study in the indoor stream?
Well, we're able to do a lot of different things. Right now, what we're looking at is how brook trout are going to adapt and cope with climate change as that happens over the next 30 to 50 to 100 years from now.
What exactly is climate change?
Yeah, climate change is many things. It's the changes in air temperature, it's changes in precipitation. We're looking at how they're blood chemistry changes, we're looking at the physiology, we're looking at their growth rates, and their behavioral changes. All of these things help us anticipate the effect of climate change on brook trout.
What else does this indoor stream help you study?
Well, it allows us to look at how fish growth rates change with different kinds of stressors in the environment. It allows us to look at how fish behavior changes with stressors. All these things help us understand where fish can survive and where they can't.
So Dr. Hitt, what exactly is this device you have in your hands?
This is a thermometer.
Now that's not something I'd want to put under my tongue.
Probably not, no. We use this to measure water temperature in the stream system. And it's an important thing to understand, especially for brook trout. They require cold water habitat. This is currently running at about 13 degrees Celsius, and that's a comfortable temperature for brook trout.
Not so comfortable for us.
It'd be a little chilly.
And today we're back out in the field, and I have with me Matt Morgan, a biological technician here with the U.S. Geological Survey at the Leetown Science Center. And of course, you guys all know my co-host Travis here. And Dan, I'm wondering, you got all this gear going on. What exactly are we looking at?
Well, what we're looking at here is a backpack electrofisher. So check this out.
I'm checking it out.
It looks like Ghostbusters, but it's even cooler than that. What this does is it sends out an electrical current from this side to this side, which trails behind me as you walk upstream. And it allows you to sample the fish that are living in the stream. It shocks them, it doesn't kill them. What happens is it'll stun fish for a second, and then we have to use these dip nets here to scoop them up. We put them in a bucket with water in it, and in a couple of seconds they snap back and they're usually fine. But we can look at the number of species that are out here, we can look at the number of individuals that are out here, and we can look at their body condition to see how they're doing. One thing to keep in mind is that there is safety involved here. So we always wear rubber gloves when we're working in the stream. We also have waders where water doesn't go through, so we don't get shocked.
Right? And of course, our life jackets to protect us from going under.
Just to be safe.
Well, instead of zapping some ghosts, why don't we zap some fish and give this thing a try?
Cool.
the gang all headed out in search of a diversity of fish. The first one to net a fish was my co-host Travis, a Blue Ridge sculpin, unique to just this region. We continued electrofishing to see what other species we could observe.
Whoa, there we go. What do we have here?
Take a look. All right, so that is our creek chub.
One fish after another came to the surface, each one with a different color, size, and shape. It's truly amazing, all the diversity that lives beneath the surface.
All right, guys, we're back out from the field. Let's take a look in the bucket. We've caught a number of different species. Dan, what are we looking at here?
This is a Blue Ridge sculpin. And Blue Ridge sculpin are special fish. The only place they live in the whole world is in the Upper Potomac River system where we are right now. All right, creek chub. Yep, you see that spot on his dorsal fin? That shows you that's a creek chub.
Dan, Matt, I want to thank you both so much for taking the time to take Travis and myself out electrofishing and seeing all the diverse fish there are in this ecosystem.
Thanks for coming out.
After a long day spent in the field, it was time to head back to the lab.
What can students do if they want to end up getting a job like yours?
Well, the first thing they can do is get outside and start paying attention. I mean, put a snorkel mask on and go to the stream and look around. You'll be amazed at what you see. The second thing is, you can start doing science. You can start doing science, doing experimental work with a class project. There are all sorts of ways that you can start doing this right now, and that kind of experience will put you on your way to this kind of work.
I couldn't agree more. Dr. Hitt, thank you so much for having us here at your fish hatchery and showing us this amazing stream system that you've built.
Well, thanks for coming.
It's really amazing when we can combine our passion using the latest technology and our love of nature to help protect our fish, our wildlife, and our wild places. We'll see you guys next time on the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Conservation Connect.